So good afternoon, everybody. On behalf of ISM Patna,
good afternoon.
It is my great pleasure to welcome you all to the orientation program 2020. I'm here to say a few introductory words about the intellectual adventure you are about to undertake. As one of the state's leading private college, ISM Patna offers different courses from which you will choose to create for yourself an education that will open new worlds and new possibilities for yourself. ISM Patna, established in the year 2010, it is the first private business school in the Bihar, recognized and approved by AICTE, HRD History School, Government of India, and affiliated to Aruba Technology University, Bihar. You will all be developing essential capacities, the knowledge, skills, and habits of mind that you will equip and thrive in an increasingly complex and interconnected world. And not only this, you will develop your professional skills and develop your personal and civic life. ISM incredibly talented faculty will be your guide and allies in your exploration. They are your greatest resource. They will change you, guide you, and open doors to new possibilities. There is a unique bonding of students with the institute through our mentor and mentee session. Apart from regular classes, we conduct various live project sessions. There is a strong academic, industry, and corporate linkage for better understanding of the curricular study. There are diverse clubs like cultural, sports, peace club, and many such clubs for overall personality development of the students. And ISM Patna, with its excellent faculty team, who are well experienced both into corporate as well as academics, is continuously treading on the path of success. In the span of 10 years, it has earned incredible recognition for its value-added approach and experimental learning. Apart from building good professionals, it also focuses on cutting-edge research. Students enjoy the ambience, and through the various access to innumerable resources, are scaling to a great height. This will ultimately help the society and in the betterment of nation. I want to know that the entire ISM Patna is here to support, sustain, and encourage you as your commitment to our college. We could not be more privileged to welcome you into this vibrant learning environment. We look forward to the fresh ideas and energy you bring to our campus. I speak on the behalf of entire faculty, staff, and student community of ISM Patna in saying we are so happy that you have made the decision to join us. So welcome once again to our family of ISM Patna. Thank you. Now I'll request up our Vice Chairman sir, who is a very philanthropic person and who, with a great initiative, has entered this field of entrepreneurial education. We are lucky, and I should say now, you also being a part of the ISM family, you are also lucky to be in his guidance. Deval sir, could you please join us? The time for the orientation program was scheduled at 3 p.m. sharp, and many participants are joining very late. So I will request for all the students to be punctual, because punctuality is a part of your professional and academic discipline and management. And in this very orientation program, this is the first step towards our college. So be punctual in your classes, be punctual in every field or aspect of your life.
Silpi ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Honorable Vice Chairman sir is joining soon, within 1 to 2 minutes.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. HR sir, will you like to say a few words to us, encourage our students? Okay, Vice Chairman sir is soon joining with us. Apart from academics, as I told you all, we have got diversified club. We have got cultural club, sports club, peace club. We do research work here. We also enhance skills. We get the personality development programs. We have personality skill and enhancement program. And we are blessed to have a new director, Mr. Padhi sir. He's a renowned academician. Apart from being academician, he is a versatile person in every field. So I would like Director sir to speak some few words to encourage our new students.
Thank you, Silpi ma'am.
Thank you, sir.
Respected Vice Chairman, sir. Dear colleagues. And my dearest students. It's a great day for not only the new students of ISM Patna, but also for me, because I am also the new face in this institute. I'm very glad to be a part of ISM family. And I welcome all the students to our campus to share their experience and exposure with the high quality faculty and infrastructure that ISM Patna provides. From my personal point of view, would not speak a lot about the institution, because it is to be experienced in person by each one of you. I have no doubt the exposure and experience into management, teaching and research for the last 4 decades. But I am proud to say that ISM Patna is an institution with a difference. It's because of two important things. One, the physical infrastructure, and the second is the quality of input. As Madam Silpi has already said, that we are emphasizing more on the co-curricular activities, including the communication skills, personality development, and the aptitude. On a regular basis, faculty members here conduct quizzes, and we have planned to go for a number of activities which would make their prospects of employability very high. Like in this particular academic year, we are planning to arrange a number of group discussion sessions, seminars, exercises, business games, and case studies. I'm sure with the kind of input that comprises of a variety of resources will be definitely useful for the students to build an excellent career in management and computing. We are also planning to go for a placement drive in a big way, which no other institution in Patna has done so far. And in this regard, sir, we are going to emerge as the leaders in management and computer education in the region. All this is possible because of our dynamic and able leader, the vice chairman of ISM Patna, who is a great source of inspiration. And with that kind of hope, he has inducted me into the system. So on behalf of the institution, I wish every faculty member and every student all the best. And at the same time, I express my gratitude, my thankfulness to the Vice Chairman, Sir Sri Deval Singh. Now, if
Doctor, sir, sorry to interrupt,
if
you,
I have to, yes, ma'am. Is it sir, my turn, or I'll be speaking later?
Sir, our Vice Chairman sir has joined, so I would like our Vice Chairman sir. Okay.
Thank you for listening to me, one and all. Thank you very much.
I will be listening you again, sir, because you are the greatest pillar of success.
No, sir. Madam, not.
Yes, sir.
So.
Now, I would like our esteemed Vice Chairman, sir, to convey some message to our students, our new students, I should say. And because of his great initiative, and as I told you, he's a great philanthropic person, and being an educational entrepreneur, he has proved to be one of the leading educational entrepreneurs of the whole state, not only of Bihar, of the whole India, because we have got many awards also because of his encouragement, his development. So, Vice Chairman, sir, please, over to you to convey some message to our students.
Good afternoon, ma'am. Good afternoon, sir. Am I audible to everyone? Is my video turned on and everybody can see?
Yes, sir. Your video is on.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So good afternoon to everyone who is present here. And first of all, thank you so much, Pali sir, for the introduction, and Shilpi ma'am. Well, for the coming batch this year, that is 2020 session, everyone is here from BBA, BCA, PGDM, all the sections are here. So first of all, congratulations for coming to ISM Patna. Now, when we talk about orientation, you need to understand that we are here to orient you towards your future, right? So in this time, I think the people who are getting enrolled into classes and courses in the year 2020, they are the people who will have like conquered major challenges in life, because coming online and getting education online for the first time in your life, that is on a daily basis and from morning to evening, let's say, it is a big push for students who have come from different backgrounds. And it is one of the challenges that you are facing as of now. And this will make you overcome greater things in the coming years. And let's hope that these online classes eventually come to an end and you all get the feeling of a physical classroom where you all can interact with each other more easily and in a better way. And I hope that you all get whatever you deserve and whatever you guys want to get from the courses that you have been enrolled into. Moving ahead towards this program, what I would like to tell you is that when you're enrolled into such courses, you only aspire to learn something, to get the knowledge out of it. But there has to be a part in which you need to understand that every course that you get into is a major step towards the person that you're trying to become in life. So try to be attentive, because these 3 years or 2 years of your life will set up a ladder for you for your coming future, where you'll go to great heights just because of what you do in these 3 or 2 years. And you'll be able to learn those things from the faculties that are here to help you out under like the dynamic, I would say, at this point of time. I've known him a lot, Padhi sir. He's a great human being, a great leader. That's why I think that the coming years that you guys are going to have at ISM are going to be wonderful, not only in terms of academics, but also in terms of co-curricular activities. The other faculty members who are here, the administrator, the people from the organizing committees, Shilpi ma'am, Neeru ma'am, everybody is going to help you out to move towards your future in a proper way. So yeah, that's all from my side. So congratulations once again, and welcome to ISM Patna. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for great motivation for the students. And as I told earlier also that here at ISM, there is a unique bonding of students with the institute. We have mentor-mentee session. We do have regular classes. Apart from the regular classes, we conduct various live project sessions. And we link the academic, the industry, and the corporate with the teaching and curricular studies and the co-curricular studies. They are diverse clubs, as I told you all. There are many clubs, and basically any college or any educational institute, main emphasis is not only learning and knowledge. We emphasize more on the overall personality development of the students. That is why we say that ISM is one of the best leading institute of Bihar. So now over to Director sir. Due to some technical issues, Deval sir joined a little bit late. Sir, Director sir, you just continue with the speech, because as I told you, you are one of the greatest pillar of success. I mean, in terms of your success stories behind your academic career, there's a great lot we'll be benefiting to our institute through your blessings and through your many innovative ideas. We are continuously conducting many webinars from ISM Patna, and as you have joined the webinars of the Teachers' Day, and many such webinars are still to be there unfolded. So Director sir, please, over to you.
Thank you, Madam Silpi. In fact, our intention is not to simply raise the level of expectation of students, but to work with them, work for them, to see them as successful entrepreneurs, successful executives and managers in future. And in order to achieve that end, mere acquisition of a few theoretical knowledge or understanding a few topics in management or computer would not help them. What is essential for a student is to develop the innate qualities of a human being. By now, I have taught not less than 20,000 students across the country. My dear students, you would be very glad to know that my birthplace was on the border city of Orissa and Andhra Pradesh, but my workplace has been the state of Bihar. I started taking a boom in my academic career as an assistant professor of BIT Mesra way back in 1986-87, when most of you might not be born. You know, you were born after 1986. Then I went back to a state university, served there as a teacher in management, served for almost 18 years as a professor and chairman in the Board of Studies of Management. Moved across the country extensively, not only inside the country, visited about 15 different countries outside the country, where I was invited to deliver my talk in conferences and seminars in management, as well as information technology. So all through, I have been a learner of this subject for the last 40 years. I would be really fortunate if a part of my learning could be shared with my beloved students, and if in turn it would help them in becoming successful human beings. That will be the main goal of my life, for which God has again sent me back to my so-called karma bhumi, that is Bihar. I will give you three important letters which are going to shape your future as a successful entrepreneur or executive, or the most successful individual. That's spelt out by a senior management consultant named Arindam Chaudhary, who calls it as the ASK principle. A-S-K. What is that? First thing is attitude. You think something as an optimist in a positive way, like something that appears before you as white is a sign of peace, something that is visible to you as black is a sign of protest. So one is the positive, the peace part. The protest one is negative. I give you a glass of water which is half filled. One student, when asked to say something about it, would say that it is half empty. Whereas another student will say that it is half full. The content remains same. The taste of water remains same. But the mindset is different. One student is saying that it is half full. Another is saying that it is half empty. One student is totally satisfied and the other one is satisfied to the extent of 50%. Now, if you say everything is available to you and that's why you are happy, it's a misnomer. Life is a combination of both happy and sorrow. If you think that everything should be available to you in order to become happy, I'm sure that time is never going to come. You ask the most prominent billionaires today as to whether they are happy, they would say, no, they'll be happy the moment they conquer the whole world. And after they conquer the whole world, you ask them, are you happy? They would say, no, we'll be happy if we conquer the whole universe. So human needs has no limits. We live in India. We also live in a part of that country where resources are limited. And despite those resources shortage, if we can think of doing something good, that will bring about a change in our society. So your day should start in thinking about it in a positive way. If someone is not happy with you, he must have a reason. Maybe that what you told him was not encouraging. Maybe you expected a friend to help you with some notes, some books which he didn't provide you. Those are the things which are responsible for your unhappiness in the long run. Never feel that you are deficient of something. Whatever you have, you try to make a culture of what you have. And gradually, when the resources are available to you abundantly, you will start enhancing your learning process. In this way, ISM is going to provide you the desired resources so that your attitude gradually gets transformed from negative to positive. And at the end of the day, I want to see that all my students have positive attitude, not only towards their fellow friends, towards their institution, but towards their life as a whole. Because I told you, if you get everything positive, you will be within the frame, you will become a god. We are all human beings, born with some deficiencies. That's why perhaps we believe in God. We believe in some kind of unseen forces which control us. Have that faith and conviction in you. Definitely you will excel in your career. Second is, yes, skill. You know, you will acquire various types of skills here. Mostly the technical skills will be imparted by various subject teachers. Those who are pursuing computer education will come across teachers who will be providing you with adequate skills relating to development of software programs. Those in the business stream would understand a lot about the accounting skills. Okay. Now, sometimes a student thinks that since he has acquired the skill, he should be treated in the best possible way, and in today's words, he should get the best employment. Now, at present, if you look at your skill, all of you are skillful in your own ways. Yet you don't find a position for you in the society in terms of getting employment or in terms of becoming an entrepreneur. Do you know what's the reason? The main reason is not simply due to lack of those few skills, but more importantly, your skill to sell yourself, which in the field of computer and management we call as the soft skills. The hard skills are the ones where you acquire the skills in the hard way. You understand about the procedure. And soft skills are those skills where you try to take off through your creativity and innovation. One of the key features of the new education policy, which is launched by the government, is aimed at that. For quite some time, we found students were in a rat race. They were chasing after the marks mindset. If you have secured 90% marks, you are identified as the best student. If someone else has secured 60% marks, then he is considered to be a student who is less competent than you. I tell you, my dear students, during the last 35 years of my teaching and 5 years into research, I have seen students with average level of intelligence are the ones who have excelled in their life and career. You might have watched the movie Three Idiots, no? What did you learn from there? What did you learn from the hero? He was not the most intelligent student. Sometimes you also come to know that he is not at all a student of that level who is worth sitting inside the class. Yet he achieves success. So your acquiring the degree is a mere passport. And if you want to excel in your career, you must have the visa, right? I have the passport through which I can travel across more than 100 countries. But the condition is that those countries must allow me to get into their territory. So in order to get the visa, you have to acquire something else. I'll give you a simple example here to explain the difference between hard skills and soft skills. All of you know that Apollo 13 was a very successful mission when man first landed on the moon, right? And there was another mission called Columbia mission, where we lost the greatest scientist of Indian origin. The Columbia mission became a disaster. It was a failure. If I ask you a question as to why Apollo 13 became a success and why Columbia mission became a failure, what will be your reply? Your reply will be appropriate or will be acceptable if you are having some knowledge about the rocket science and aerodynamics. Some scientists say that there was a breakage somewhere, so the air went inside and space shuttle was burned, but we don't know the reason, the exact reason behind that. But one thing that comes to our mind, that there was a technical problem. And when you are dealing with a mathematical problem, where the teacher has given you the formula A plus B whole square, if you write A square B square plus 2AB square, will it be correct? No, it won't be correct. So if a question is asked as to what is the net result of A plus B whole square, you have to explain it exactly. If there is a little deviation, then it will lead to disastrous consequence, like the one in which we lost Kalpana Chawla, the greatest scientist of Indian origin, in the Columbia mission. This is what is the hard skill. Hard skill is earned in a very hard way. Something which is hard is to be followed absolutely without any change, without any difference. Like A plus B's whole square cannot be explained in your own way, right? There is a set of formula for which the set of answer is also fixed. I'll give you the example of soft skill here. There was a flight from Singapore to London. Near London, the airport is Heathrow Airport. On board the flight, when the flight was moving very high in the sky, at that particular moment, an old lady of 75 years, developed a chest pain. Okay, it was such a critical case that unless immediate medical attention was given to that lady, the old lady would have died. On that flight, a doctor named Angus Wallace was traveling. Listen to me carefully. The dotted lines which are to be understood by you. The doctor could realize the problem, and he carried out a minor surgery, because the chest of that lady had been choked. Jaise abhi ho raha hai in the corona time, the blood circulation is choked, and after that the patient dies. Similar kind of a situation happened. The doctor had two choices: either to carry out a minor surgery and save that lady, or to let the situation go like that and allow that lady to die. So Angus Welles chose the second option. It was not an operation theater, it was a flight. He was on board the flight. But he was carrying a bottle of brandy with him. He had his minor surgical equipments with him. He could carry out that operation, minor surgery, on that lady, and the congestion on the lady's lungs, problem which the lady was facing, was resolved. By the time the flight reached Heathrow Airport, The relatives of that old lady were waiting, because after that the flight took a halt on the way, because from Singapore to Heathrow the flight doesn't move at a stage. It went for a halt on the way. Then the relatives of the old lady, as well as the members of Singapore Airlines, also got the information. So a large crowd was waiting, not only to see that old lady, but to see this doctor. Look at this doctor, what kind of quality he had. Even when the flight was in the sky, he could carry out the operation and save the life of the old lady. So, my dear students, in your life, you will come across two different types of situation. One is the hard situation where you apply all the hard principles, like you are learning of mathematics, accounting. Okay? These are the subjects where you will have to come across hard principles. There is no compromise to that, because a little compromise there will give you the wrong answer and the teacher will not accept it and you will get failed. So I am not your ill-wisher to say like that, right? The other side is the softer side, where you have both the choices. You have your own discretion. When you find that the situation is becoming worse, it's running out of your hand, you start going beyond the boundary, right? In the latest terms, we call it as out-of-box thinking. You start operating within the box, you call it hard skill. You start thinking out of box, the way Angus Welles, the doctor who traveled by Singapore Airlines, felt, it is out of box. So you have to possess both the things, the hard and soft skills, in order to achieve success in your career. And third one is knowledge. What is knowledge? How could you differentiate a knowledgeable person from that of an idiot? That's why I gave you the example of three idiots, right? They were not three idiots. So my students are also not going to become idiots. They will be knowledgeable. Try to apply the available knowledge to your environment. Like people speak many big things, like what happens in USA, what happens in UK and Australia, like that. But they never try to assess the situation in its reality. So your assessment of reality is the best knowledge that you are going to get. Like what the teacher teaches inside the class needs to be further refined by you through group discussion. Through small projects, maybe say during the summer, which ice cream is preferred by people in Patna? You move out in consultation with your teacher, have 10 to 12 questions with you, go to a small shop, sit there for 10 minutes, get some idea, and then start working it out with your marketing teacher. Say, madam or sir, ice cream is not sold in this way in which it is taught in the theory. In the field, we find a difference. And the moment you start experimenting on this, what is taught inside the class is experimented through small projects, through seminars, through group discussion. Then only you will be refining your knowledge and you will be achieving success in your life. I pray God, each one of you will achieve success in your life and career. We are here to nurture you. We are here to take care of you. God bless you all. Thank you very much. Thank you, dear students.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for enlightening our new students with your so much enlightening speech. And yes, I do agree, this is a God-sent arrangement that we have landed to our college, the International School of Management, Patna. We are very lucky to have a director like you. Now I will request Pooja Dubey ma'am to give vote of thanks.
Thank you, Shilpi ma'am. Am I audible?
Yes,
yes ma'am. You're audible. Yes, ma'am, you're audible.
Okay. Good evening, one and all present here. The best and beautiful things in the world must be felt by heart. Thank you is one such prayer among them. I consider it to be a great privilege to propose a vote of thanks to the distinguished persons who have witnessed this memorable and successful event. I, Pooja Dubey, assistant professor, on behalf of ISM Patna and the entire fraternity of the institute, would like to thank to the chairman, ISM Patna, Sri Samrendra Singh Ji sir, whose words always enlighten and motivate every team member to take initiative and give their best. My deep sense of gratitude is also for the vice chairman, ISM Patna, Sri Devan Singh Ji sir, who graced us with his thoughts provoking and interesting address. I would also thank to Dr. Prashanta Padi sir, director ISM Patna, for his support and timely monitoring in every aspect of our activities at ISM Patna. I specifically thank the people who have been the architecture of this event. This is Neeru Kumari Jha ma'am, administrator ISM Patna, Mr. Abhishek Anand sir, HR manager ISM Patna, who have toiled hard to organize this event. Mrs. Silpi Kavita ma'am, chairperson cultural committee, also needs a special thanks for organizing this event effectively. Definitely, events like this cannot happen overnight. So the wheel started rolling week ago and required planning and bird eye view of the program. We are fortunate enough to be backed by a team of very dedicated and motivated teaching and non-teaching staff of ISM Patna, who helped us in making this orientation program a very resounding success. Last but not least, I thank all the dear students for their benign presence, and my message for all of them that the deeper they work on yourself, the wider your impact will be. Keep these words in your mind, go ahead and keep signing. Once again, thank you very much to one and all present here who have witnessed this event. Thank you so much. Yes, over to Shilpi ma'am.
Thank you, Pooja ma'am, for such a wonderful vote of thanks. We are really thankful to every person associated with this orientation program 2020. And a special thanks to our Vice Chairman sir, Director sir, and Pooja Dubey ma'am, who made this orientation program a wonderful session. I hope students have enjoyed this orientation program. This was the day one of the orientation program. Tomorrow we will be interacting with many industry leaders, because the real future of all the students here are the industry. So we are trying to connect, as I told you in my introductory speech, that we try to connect the students with industry, the corporate sector. And we try to prove that we, International School of Management, is one of the best institute, not only in Bihar, we'll prove in near future, under the guidance of a new director, sir, to be one of the best institute of the world. So we all need cooperation from the student side also. So with this, I say that we'll be again rejoining tomorrow. The time and the schedule and the link will be shared tomorrow. And all the students are requested to kindly mark the attendance. I've shared the attendance link. Please mark the attendance link. Thank you very much. Thank you, everybody.